So schools, that is a place where we entrust teachers to take care of our kids. I don't have any kids in school right now, but I know there's plenty of people here watching and people we talk to on this couch quite a bit that they have their kids in schools and they just don't trust the schools anymore. And then now when there's a new variant coming out, it's a virus. There's always going to be a new variant coming out, and we're censoring, or the big tech is censoring legit information about the variant and then how that actually affects kids. And there's been legit information that comes out and says, these kids, they are not being affected. They are not transmitting this disease, but they're shutting down schools. And they're telling these kids, once again, you got to do online learning. Newsflash, not every single kid has a brand new MacBook that they can go home and learn from. Mm-hmm. Not every kid or family has the ability to basically do daycare. Yeah.
But according to Joe Biden, they can go sit on the curb at McDonald's and get the free Wi-Fi, which is a great TikTok. These kids don't have access to stuff like this. No. So many children in America have been lost. Literally, that's the word that's being used by the Department of Education when it comes to their schooling, because we don't know where they are. They're not going to school. They're not logging on to do things online. When things are in person, they're not showing up. What's going to happen to an entire generation of kids that haven't been educated?
There's hundreds of schools too in LA County and Chicago that are closed right now. Like you can't even take your kid to school. You don't even have the option.
Denver,
at all.
I think, is online too right now.
Yep.
Back up. I feel like we should call it what it is. The teachers' unions across the country used kids as hostages and negotiating techniques to get more money, which is effectively what they did. The federal government gave them $130 billion freaking dollars. And the whole reason they gave him $1 billion was to keep kids safe at school. And now we're back home. What did you do with $130 billion, guys?
Demanded raises and donated to political campaigns.
Probably put it into their unfunded pension liabilities, because that's what's going to bankrupt California.
And that's what I was saying earlier when I was teasing this segment. It's all under the guise of health and safety.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And at what point are we going to have more parents and more people that can really enact change rise up and say, this is wrong? You can't keep using this phrase as justification of what you're doing, because it's hurting kids. Mm-hmm. And once again, I know I've said it a zillion times. Absolutely. I remember growing up hearing about other places across the world where, like, reading and writing and math and science, they are way ahead of us. What are we gonna do? Mm-hmm. And if they're acting like this is gonna be good for kids and this isn't gonna have ramifications for generations from now, you're delusional.
This is Charlie Kirk, founder and CEO of Turning Point USA. If you liked this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel at Turning Point USA.